What's up guys, this is Arish on behalf of Cinemaskill and I'm here to do a vlog. So today we're gonna talk about animator problems. What problems do animators have? I'll tell you what problems animators have. So I started animating way back in 2008. That's when I started my animation classes. And now it's 2013, it's 5 years now. So I think I know something about animators because I started doing freelance works from 2010, so three years on the freelance road. So I'll tell you why freelancers basically do it. It's because every animation studio or every other places we go to, they ask for experience, at least 2 years or 3 years experience. Where are we gonna get the experience if we don't even work? I mean, we don't even get any fresher jobs. So it's gonna be it's kind of hard for animators to get a job nowadays. And each and every person, like lots of people have come to, let me just get this off, lots of people have come and asked me, and they're like POC, especially people who are studying POC, they're like, dude, anyways, this year I'm finishing POC, or people who are doing second POC, they'll be like, some are like, dude, I'm definitely gonna fail POC, I wanna join animation. What do you think animation is? You just come in, you learn stuff, you earn money. You think that's all? You have to be creative. See, people who have gone to big heights, like when I started working for animations, people think, oh my god, when I join animation, I'm gonna get paid a lot. Starting salary 30k, 40k. Oh my god, this is gonna be awesome. No, I'm telling you for the last time, no, it's not gonna be like that. It's not that easy. Trust me. The first time I started doing my work, the first work I did was for 400 bucks. So that's Indian money for all the other folks out there. That'd be 400 bucks for you will be like $20. I don't know, probably $20. No, $20 is 100 bucks. No, $20 is a lot. It's 1000 bucks. 400 bucks comes to about $8. So $8 for what I did my first work for, and 400 bucks for the Indian people. So don't keep your imaginations high when you come into the animation field, please. And when I was in my institute, I've been into 3 institutes till date, in animation institutes, and all 3 and the last one too, I've seen a lot of people who just come in like just now I explained, right? So they just come in to earn money. They're like, see, I'm here because I failed POC, or I just finished POC and I want to start animating. If you ask them why you want to start animating, they'll be like, I think it's a cool job. I know how to draw and all. So I think animation is my thing. Please keep your self-esteem down. Because see, basically when I started animating, that's when animation classes started in India. So I didn't even know what animation is. I just went as a summer camp course. So the first thing I went for was a DCA course, a Diploma in Computer Applications. And I did the course very fast. So they had like 3 months more for my course to finish, and I had finished it even earlier. So they told, we'll teach you some 3D softwares. That's basically what has come now as a free course. So then if you like it, you can just start over. So that's how I started it. People started training me on their own. I didn't go like I want money and I started animating. So people who start there might get their chances into the field because they have a lot of experience and a lot of softwares have been upgraded and introduced into the field since then. But people who are starting right now, just be careful guys. It's not, the field is not that, what do you say, stable for you guys to stand on. I might be a little discouraging here, but that's how it rolls here. Because if you don't have the creativity to get in, please don't get in. And I encourage everybody to get into animation, but seriously, please work. Most of the guys who came into my institute, they'll be like, oh my god, animation. They'll come, attend the classes, and they'll leave. That's it. They pass their exams, they do everything. Most of the people who get the highest scores in the exams, if you tell them to practically do something, they can't. They can't practically see. I've created, you can see some of my models on my 3D models on my profile on Facebook, but it took me a long time to get through those because I never studied theory. I never studied theory. All my training basically came from my teachers. They were really good teachers. I had 3 good teachers, Charit, Srivasa and Santosh, they were really awesome teachers. These people taught me very well, like even all the teachers whom I didn't mention, these were the first three that came to my mind, but everyone supported me so much because I had that interest in me. But I've seen lots of people have that interest too. Most of the people who come up in the animation, like even in my classes, most of the people who came up like as big heads in animation, the students, they all didn't do much of a theory. The people who did theory, like you won't tell them, if you tell them to do some practical stuff, they are a little bit down over there. So my training, basically before I started animation, like when they started the summer camp course I told you, after that I was for the 2 years or 3 years, something like that, I was basically not going anywhere, I was studying my school. So at that time, basically my teacher was the internet, everything. I had a very slow connection, like 100 kbps or something, that's the first one I had. Even at that speed, I learned Photoshop, I learned 3ds Max, I learned Cinema 4D, I learned Maya, many softwares, and then I knew how to enter the animation field, because I even saw many videos and how the animation field is growing in India. I did lots of R&D and then got into the field. So people who are trying to get into the field, just know where you're gonna be in a few years. Just see, basically just know your position, just learn to accommodate to your situations. Like if you're getting paid $1,000, it's good because $1,000 is a lot for a startup. So it's not gonna be really lucky for you guys to get a 25,000 30,000 job at the starting. That's all I'm saying here. If you get into the animation, awesome, I'm welcoming you like this is the best thing to do in the world. But if you're expecting too much pay in the animation field, don't just come in, please don't come in. So the other thing I want to say is, people who are paying for freelancers, come on guys, we do the work. The work we do is worth more than that. Because people basically come to us and be like, come on, it's just a 10 minutes job, just finish it in 10 minutes and it's done. See, it's basically took me 5 years and 10 minutes to do that job. 5 years of experience told me what tools to use in that software and what moves to do in the mouse and what creature or what logo to create. 5 years of experience has got me here where you are trusting me to do your job. That's how it works. So basically pay a little more, $800 for a logo. That's how I started. I started doing $400 a logo, and now I know that was really low, because nowadays logos in the companies are being made for $5,000-$6,000, and I'm still waiting here for a logo guy to come up and be like, I want you to make a logo. So I'm still not starting up with freelance, because no one has given me an order. Still I'm open for freelance guys, if you want to give me some clients, so you can get me some clients and YouTube videos. This next thing, that's about it for today's vlog guys. I just wanted to talk about animation field and how it's gonna get in, and how you can get in and all. So the next thing is, the vlogs are coming up like pretty soon nowadays, but I'm not being able to edit it. That's all, that's the only thing. I've been recording lots of vlogs, but I'm not being able to edit them. So the thing is, this is the third vlog of Cinema Skull. That's the first vlog was the shotgun, the second vlog was the parents and internet, and the third vlog is this one, animation problems. So the fourth one, I want you guys to decide it. Comment here, comment on Facebook, comment on Twitter, anywhere, retweet this, reply to me, mail me, any ideas you got, your personal ideas, your public, public ideas, anything like common interest, anything you got, just mail them in or comment them, anything you have, just tell them to me and I'll try making my best video to make them hilarious and also fun to watch. And I know this video wasn't that hilarious, but this was supposed to be a serious video and it has been a serious video. And if you want some hilarious shit, here it is. Okay, I shouldn't have done that. Anyways, so that's about it for today's video guys. I'll catch you up later with another video of Cinema Skull. Let's vlog with Arish. No, that's not the cutscene, wait. So please like the video, subscribe to us, and please share the video guys. I'm telling everyone to share the video, share the video. So that's what's been happening. Please share the video, guys. It gives a lot of exposure to vloggers like us. We are also trying to get some video views. I'm not basically earning, I'm just doing videos for you guys. So please understand that and share the video. And thank you for watching. This is Sari shining off. Shining? Bling. Okay. This is Sari signing off from Cinemas Kalan. I'll catch you next time with another vlog that you decide.